welcome you're logged on to IndianTimesToday.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages, and our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Annie Sheikh and today's headlines are: In India, the government has inked a $5.4 billion deal to buy the S-400 missiles from Russia, and the rupee collapsed to a lifetime low of ₹74.20 on Friday. In Punjab, the state has deferred its decision on the reduction of fuel prices, and the centre will provide ₹500 crore for food procurement. In Canada, PM Trudeau has promised compensation for dairy, and India's biggest festivals, Diwali, will be celebrated at the iconic Niagara Falls. Stay tuned to IndianTimesToday.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab.
Have you been denied long-term disability benefits or have your benefits been terminated? If your claim for disability benefits is denied, you should be given a reason. Insurance companies have an internal appeal process. However, it is difficult to alter their decision using this internal process. Therefore, we recommend retaining a lawyer immediately after your claim is terminated or denied. Call an experienced long-term disability claims lawyer at Kotak Personal Injury Law. We will fight for your right to receive the benefits you deserve.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: The government has ignored threats by the US to impose sanctions and went ahead with a deal to procure the S-400 Triumph air defense missiles from Russia. India is buying 5 systems costing around US $5.4 billion. This will provide an umbrella coverage against any airborne threats like fighter jets, missiles, UAVs, etc. The BSE Sensex fell over 800 points on Friday, extending its losing run for the third day, even as the RBI's bi-monthly policy kept repo rates unchanged amid weak global cues. The 30-share index, after crackling the 35,000 mark, touched a low of 34,267. The rupee collapsed to a lifetime low of ₹74.20. In a blistering attack on the Modi government, Congress President Rahul Gandhi has said that it has gone into a war with its own people, imposing a single suffocating ideology on 1.3 billion Indians. He added that people's aspirations was turning into anger. The Devendra Fadnavis government in Maharashtra is under fire from Dalit leaders. This is for allegedly reducing the size of the statue of Babasaheb Ambedkar, which is coming up in central Mumbai. The UN has voiced alarm over India's deportation of 7 Rohingya men to Myanmar. This is despite warnings that they could face persecution in a country where the military is accused of genocide against the Muslim minority. Militants have shot dead 2 political workers and injured another by firing at them from a close range in Karfali Mohalla area of the city. This comes 2 days ahead of polling for first phase of elections for urban local bodies in Kashmir. The Delhi High Court has acquitted former TV anchor and producer Suhaib Ilyasi in his wife's murder case. The bench allowed the appeal of Ilyasi, challenging his conviction and life imprisonment for killing his wife Anju 18 years ago. Ilyasi had shot into limelight after hosting TV crime show India's Most Wanted. A New Delhi-bound spice jet flight made an emergency landing on Friday at Lal Bahadur Shastri International Airport. This is after a Thai national on board suffered a heart attack. Ravindra Jadeja scored a maiden test century on Friday as India posted a mammoth 649 in the first innings of the first test against West Indies. Playing in his 38th test match, Jadeja remained not out at 100 before skipper Virat Kohli decided to declare the innings. He reached the three-figure mark in 132 balls. Actress Deepika Padukone has said that the hashtag MeToo movement is about the victory of right over wrong and should not be reduced to men versus women. She was asked about the hashtag MeToo movement in the light of Tanushree Dutta's allegations of harassment against Nana Patekar. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
Realize your ambition of becoming a doctor at All Saints University School of Medicine. With small class sizes, affordable tuition and worldwide clinical clerkships, All Saints University brings a world of opportunity right to your feet. University and high school graduates are eligible for admission. To learn more, call us at 416-743-9222 or visit us at www.allsaintsuniversity.org.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: The state has deferred its decision on the reduction of the fuel prices. Meanwhile, CM Amrinder Singh has directed the finance and excise departments to make a detailed analysis of fuel prices in Punjab and other states before taking any decision. Union Food and Public Distribution Minister Ram Vilas Paswan has assured CM Amrinder Singh that the centre will give Rs 500 crore to the state. Singh had earlier protested that due to the centre's delay in taking decisions, the state was finding it hard to fill the gap in the food cash credit account. Sikh hardliners have attacked the cavalcade of SAD Chief Sukhbir Singh Badal in Sangrur. They raised slogans against Badal, accusing him of ordering the 2015 Behbal Kalam firing. Cabinet Minister Navjot Singh Sidhu has claimed that a show cause notice has been served on a private multi-system operator in cable business by Director General of GST Intelligence. The operator company was allegedly evading service tax of Rs 2,100 crore. CM Amrinder Singh has written to Union Minister Nitin Gadkari seeking expeditious approval for revised alignment of the proposed Delhi-Amritsar-Katra Expressway. The state in 2017 had submitted the proposal for the expressway. The police have solved the parcel bomb case with the arrest of Rajbir Rajera, a president of Uttar Pradesh's Sundargarh district. Cops claim that Rajbir had planted the bomb with the aim of murdering his cousin Rupesh Rajena, a Sangrur resident, over a property dispute. The Aam Aadmi Party disciplinary panel meeting has decided to defer any action on indiscipline in the party. It claimed that the peace between the warring groups might be given another chance following the formation of a 22-member core committee to run the state unit. The Panchkula court has granted a regular bail to Dehra Sachhsagar chief Gurmeet Ram Rahim Singh in the case involving castration of his followers. However, Ram Rahim will remain in jail as he is serving a sentence over the rape of two of his women followers. The will reimbursed Rs 2 crore to the state, which it had spent on giving compensation to families that migrated to the state following the 1984 anti-Sikh riots. This is for one-time extension of stipulated cut-off date from November 8, 2016 to August 4, 2017. Delhi's toxic smog has exercised the minds of many a problem solver, but a solution may finally be in the sight. Chandikabon architect Najmus Chaudhary has developed a unique project that involves a network of giant towers which will absorb Delhi's polluted air and belt out breathable one. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Canada follows.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: PM Justin Trudeau has pledged that dairy farmers will be compensated for the expected losses under the new USMCA. Trudeau met with dairy representatives in downtown Montreal amid concerns that they are bearing the brunt under the recently concluded Free Trade Pact. India's biggest festival, Diwali, will be celebrated at Canada's iconic Niagara Falls this year. The celebration is being organized by the Indo-Canadian Arts Council on October 14, 3 weeks ahead of the original date, as the weather will not be favorable by then. Canada recorded its first trade surplus for more than 18 months in August as unusually timed shutdowns at auto plants helped cut imports at a greater rate than exports. The surplus of $526 million recorded was the first since December 2016. PM Justin Trudeau has announced the beginning of construction on the Gordie Howe Bridge between Detroit and Windsor. The 2.5-kilometer bridge, slated to cost $5.7 billion, is expected to be completed by 2024. Federal officials said that there will be no problem in adding Manitoba to the growing list of provinces where Ottawa will have to apply a carbon tax. Environment Minister Catherine McKenna's office said that Ottawa is completely on the track to implement the carbon tax by January 1st. Canada's job market gained 63,000 positions in September, edging the unemployment rate lower to 5.9% and offsetting job losses in August. September's increase in the employment was largely driven by gains in part-time work, and with part-time jobs up by around 80,000. Authorities in Canada's Arctic North are scrambling to transport critical supplies to three isolated communities after the early arrival of sea ice. Ballachuk, Kugratuk and Cambridge Bay with a combined population of 3,000 have been unable to receive shipments of food, fuel and lumber. Intergovernmental Affairs Minister Dominic Lee Blanc, hit with a leukemia diagnosis last late year, has got the good news that he is now under complete remission. Lee Blanc underwent 6 treatments of chemoimmunotherapy intravenously over 2 days every month. NDP leader Jagmeet Singh, Chief of Staff Willie Blome, has resigned citing personal reasons. Veteran NDP MP Charlie Angus said that the surprise resignation of Blome is the beginning of the big reset as the NDP tries to gain traction with voters ahead of next year's federal election. Sophie Grigroy Trudeau has presided over the official naming of Canada's first Arctic and offshore patrol ship. HMCS Harry de Wolf has been named after the former Vice Admiral who oversaw the rescue of 42 sailors from HMCS Athabaskan in April 1944 during the Second World War. This is the end of the news bulletin. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Scans Accounting.
A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.
Actress Kajol will next be seen in the film Helicopter Ela, where she plays the role of a single mother and aspiring singer. The film will also see Riddhi Sen as Kajol's son. After the recreated version of Ruk Ruk Ruk, the makers have now released another song titled Duba Duba. The song shows Kajol romancing with her husband and after that, how she raises her son in the absence of her husband. The scenes between Kajol and Riddhi are both emotional and endearing. Arijit Singh and Sunidhi Chauhan have done complete justice to the song. The official handle of the film shared the song and wrote, "Experience all the heartwarming feelings of Helicopter Ela in the song Duba Duba out now." The film is slated to release on October 12th, which also stars Neha Dhupia in a supporting role. Directed by Pradeep Sarkar and produced by Ajay Devgan under production of Pen Movies, Helicopter Ela is marking a comeback of Kajol on the big screen after 3 years. We do know the close-knit relationship that late actress Sridevi and ace fashion designer Manish Malhotra shared, and after her demise, we get to see a lot more of Sridevi's daughter, Janhvi Kapoor, spending time with the designer. Janhvi Kapoor turned Malhotra's muse as she turned his bride for the latest photo shoot. If you take a look at Manish Malhotra's world, you will see a series of photographs where the lady is looking elegant in different ensembles as a bride. Janhvi, in a behind-the-scenes video shared by Malhotra, speaks about her relationship with the designer. Besides, on work front, post Dhadak, Kapoor has now signed a multi-star film, Takht. The movie also stars Ranveer Singh, Alia Bhatt, Vicky Kaushal, Bhumi Pednekar, Kareena Kapoor and Anil Kapoor. Ranveer Singh is excited to work in Karan Johar's historical drama Takht and says he left at the opportunity of collaborating with the filmmaker. Ranveer will be seen playing the role of Dara Shikoh in the film. Ranveer told IANS, "I'm very excited to be working with Karan Johar for the first time. We've been wanting to collaborate for a long time and it's finally happening, and it's happening in the best and biggest way possible. Takht is an amazing story. I left at this opportunity to play Dara Shikoh, who is one of the most fascinating characters that I've ever come across. A hero in the truest sense." The Padmavat star added, "Karan Johar has put together a stellar cast and a technical crew. I'm very, very excited to be collaborating with these accomplished individuals." Takht will tell story of a family, ambition, greed, betrayal, love and succession. It is being produced by Hero Yash Johar and Apoorv Mehta for release in 2020. It also features Kareena Kapoor Khan, Alia Bhatt, Anil Kapoor, Bhumi Pednekar, Vicky Kaushal and late veteran actress Sridevi's daughter, Janhvi Kapoor. Actor Shakti Kapoor is proud father of actress Shraddha Kapoor, who is running high on success with her film Stree, which so far earned Rs. 127 crore. Citing example of his daughter's film, Shakti Kapoor says that small budget films can also do well at the box office.
तो मेरी खुद की बेटी की पिक्चर है स्त्री जो 125 करोड़ ऑलरेडी क्रॉस कर चुकी है. राजकुमार, श्रद्धा कपूर, बिकॉज द फिल्म वॉज हैविंग अ लॉट ऑफ ब्यूटिफुल कंटेंट इन द फिल्म, पीपल लाफ्ड इन द फिल्म, दे स्केयर्ड, गॉट स्केयर्ड इन द फिल्म, उस फिल्म ने हिस्ट्री क्रिएट कर दी है. तो मुझे वही लग रहा है कि इसमें मतलब मैं एज एन एक्टर जितना कर सकता था किया, लेकिन उससे ऊपर एडिटर, प्रोड्यूसर, म्यूज़िक और लड़की ने भी बहुत अच्छा काम किया है. शी इज़ डन वंडरफुल जॉब. आई फील कि ये फिल्म लोगों को बहुत पसंद आएगी एंड इट शुड क्रिएट अ न्यू गेट फॉर लॉट ऑफ न्यू डायरेक्टर्स एंड प्रोड्यूसर्स.
Talking about his children, Shraddha and Siddhant's marriage, Shakti Kapoor said,
"Aajkal bachche khud dhoond lete hain aur maa baap agar dhoond ke laaye hain to matlab main to hamesha bolta hu mere dono bachchon ko, Siddhant Kapoor, Shraddha Kapoor ko, ko bhaiya aap jab bolenge to hum log aapke liye line laga denge ladkon ki, bete ko bolta hai ladkiyon ki, kyunki aap dono bahut acche hain, padhe likhe hain, aapka parivar acha hai." और बाकी पढ़े लिखे हैं, अमेरिका से पढ़ के आई है वो, बट माइंड उसका बिल्कुल बैलेंस्ड है. आपको यकीन नहीं होगा कि सारी प्रार्थनाएं उनको मालूम है, गणपति में सारी प्रार्थनाएं वो करती है, गाती है. और सेम मेरे बेटे के बारे में है, हिंदू संस्कृति उनके मतलब परिवार में मेरे सास ससुर के वहाँ से आई. मेरी बीवी शिवांगी, पद्मनी की बहन तेजस्वनी, ये लोग, पद्मनीनाथ मेरे ससुर जी संगीतकार, तो ये लोग बहुत रिलीजन को मानते हैं, तो ये संस्कृति इनके पास है, दोनों बच्चों के पास है. तो मैं भगवान से वही प्रार्थना करूँगा कि भैया ज़िंदगी में अच्छा परिवार मिले, अच्छा लड़का मिले, उसे अच्छी लड़की मिले, बाकी ऊपर वाला मालिक है. सर मैं 100% ग्रीन सिग्नल दूंगा सर, क्योंकि उनकी चाहत उनकी ज़िंदगी है. अभी और मैंने भी लव मैरिज की थी, मेरी वाइफ महाराष्ट्र ने, मैं पंजाबी हूँ, तो आई हैव नो ऑब्जेक्शन.
Rumors are doing the rounds that Shraddha, who will next be seen in the Indian shuttler Saina Nehwal's biopic, is down with the dengue. Actor Varun Dhawan reprised superstar Salman Khan and lived in his shoes for the movie Jurwa 2, which was a blockbuster movie. Jurwa 2 also saw a cameo of superstar in the movie. Now it is said that the former will be seen in a special appearance role in Bharat. Knowing that Salman Khan is busy shooting for his forthcoming movie, Varun Dhawan was seen accompanying the actor at the airport on Thursday, giving life to the speculations. The airport also witnessed the energy of Bollywood's live wire Ranveer Singh, whose casual cool attitude spread across people besides him. Meanwhile, going back to Bharat, the movie will also feature Disha Patni, Nora Fatehi, Tabu and Katrina Kaif, who replaced Priyanka Chopra after she walked out of the movie.